tree. How much fun is gonna be together? This Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright. We're caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Da 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 da. Shake a hand, shake a hand now. Presents and cards are here, our world is filled with cheer and you. This Christmas, and as I twinkle around, your eyes outshine the town, yes they do. This Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright, with caroling through the night. Me and my drum,
as the drum is our heartbeat, right? So
yeah.
Our
heartbeat.
Thank you. Thank you guys. I appreciate you.
Yeah.
I don't have a green light.
Is it on?
Thank you. All right. Rap pum pum and da 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 da. Those are two things I can sing along with. So thank you guys for getting us started this morning. Welcome to Unity on Greenville. It is the fourth Sunday of Advent. We just celebrated the winter solstice. It's Christmas Eve. Christmas Day, it's tomorrow. And Kwanzaa starts on Tuesday. Ah, when they say it's a magical time of the year, it's a magical several days just within this window. So many things to celebrate, observe, be thankful for, and so many forms in which to do it. So we are indeed blessed. My name is L.D. Carter. I'm your celebration assistant this morning. And I just have a few things I want to share with you as we get started. Hey, did you advance me? Thank you. If I were here from Never Give Up Entertainment, thank you guys for being here. And looking all festive as well as sounding all festive. We appreciate it. We always enjoy your music, so thanks for sharing it with me, with us. So much talent there. Thank you, thank you. A few things to share with you this morning. Would you advance me? I just love my thing. It worked a few minutes ago.
Oh, what did I do?
That wasn't me. Speakers. We're continuing our series of guest speakers, and it's moving without me. Okay, I'm going to talk about guest speakers. You can catch up with me. We're continuing our series of guest speakers, and we are so grateful to have back with us Reverend Veronica Valles this morning. Would you give her a Unity welcome? So she's going to be leading us in our morning meditation, also our lesson, as well as a few other wonderful seasonal things she's going to be doing for us this morning. So glad you're back with us on this very special day. A reminder that we will be doing our burning bowl ceremony on the first Sunday at December. Actually, we're going to be December 31st, sorry, because it's a New Year's Eve thing. So we will not be doing New Year's Eve service where we usually do a burning bowl. We're going to be doing it at the morning service. So please plan on that. If you have not been to Unity for a burning bowl service, that is a time in which we take account of things that we have in our lives, things that we're carrying, and we prepare to release them. So I won't give you all the details, but please plan on coming for the burning bowl service and plan on letting go of all that stuff that's weighing you down, that's occupying space, and make space for the new and wonderful things that will be coming your way. Thank you so much, all of you who support this ministry, and we want to give others the opportunity to give. If Unity on Greenville is a place where you are spiritually fed or you are blessed by its fellowship, we appreciate your financial support. There's tons of ways in which you can do that. If you're here this morning, there's a bowl at the foyer there where you can drop your offering off this morning. If you're one of our wonderful souls that are worshiping with us from long distance this morning, thank you for being with us. You can make your contribution through a number of ways. You can go to the dallasuni.org and click on the donate button there and make a gift. You can do it through Titherly by texting. Also on the screen is a barcode. So if you're really techno, you can scan that and it'll take you directly to the opportunity to make your gift. Thank you so much. If you're a geezer like me and you like snail mail, the address for the church is on the screen. You can write a check and drop it in the mail. Thank you for blessing us with your gifts. You know, we believe here that to be open to the good that we receive and then letting that good flow out again. This is one of those opportunities to do that, just to demonstrate that. We appreciate it. With intention, let's express our gratitude for those gifts that we've already received here and that for those that are yet to come. that offering blessing is on the screen. Would you say it with me? Divine love, as me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. With gratitude, we commit to using our gifts for good. Amen. Now for our daily word. The word for today is joy. It is Sunday, December 24th, 2023. The affirmation, with joy I prepare for the rebirth of the Christ within. Christmas Eve brings back memories of childhood anticipation. What's in the packages under the tree? What other goodies will be there in the morning? Now I relish the anticipation of the joy my gifts will bring as I watch my loved ones opening their presents. This joy blooms in my heart as the Advent season draws to a close, and I prepare to receive my most precious gift, the rebirth of Christ within. I still my mind and become present. I contemplate the awe of the shepherds as they heard of Jesus' birth. I think of the veneration of the kings who traveled to honor him. I surrender my feelings of awe and reverence, preparing for the joyous rebirth of life, light, and love within me. I'll read that again. I surrender my feelings of awe and reverence, preparing for the joyous rebirth of light and love within me. And our scripture is from Luke, the 2nd chapter and the 10th verse, and it says, but the angel said to them, do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. Now let's repeat our affirmation together. With joy, I prepare for the rebirth of the Christ within. As I said, it is the 4th Sunday of Advent. I'm going to ask Lamar Lester to come forward right now. And Lamar is going to share with us the message for the Advent season for the 4th Sunday.
Morning.
Good
morning. 4th Sunday Advent. The word is joy. The joy that is quiet, the joy that fills our hearts with love and our eyes with tears, is the joy that brings us home to ourselves. That joy is ours when we touch the peace and perfection of the divine and know deep in our hearts that God is not separate from us. And never was. At the end of our Advent journey, we finally arrived through faith, peace, love, and joy at the home we can never leave. We realize at the deepest level that we are in God, fully human and fully divine, and the Christ born anew. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. John 15:11. In the affirmation, I feel joyous as I celebrate the birth of the Christ within. Thank you.
Thank you, Lamar. And now Donna Kirby is going to come forward. Donna is our prayer chaplain for today. If you wish to have individual prayer, Donna is going to be available after the service at the back of the sanctuary and would be happy to pray with you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas Eve.
Merry Christmas Eve.
I have a frog in my throat this morning. You'll have to excuse me. Let's just close our eyes if you're comfortable doing so. And take a deep breath as we settle in for a short prayer. Divine Spirit, we gather with such joy to celebrate the birth of the Jesus Christ. This is a remarkable time of the year. So many events, so much love. Let us express an intention of keeping that love throughout the year. Keeping the joy that we share today throughout the year. Allow us to make it our norm. We are so honored to be a part of this congregation, of this church, whether it's in the sanctuary or virtually. We are all one. Share your joy and your love forevermore. And so it is. Amen.
So in that beautiful consciousness established, I just invite you to just take another deep breath in. And as you breathe in that love of God, let the joy of God be released in that exhale, in this dance of the divine. And as you notice your body sitting here in this beautiful sacred space, giving thanks for all that we have and all that is coming, and that joyful anticipation of the birth of Christ, let joy fill your heart with every breath. So we breathe in love. And as you exhale, radiate joy from your heart, bringing that childlike awareness of wonder and awe of the way the divine shows up so beautifully, even in the midst of conditions of the world. And for these next few minutes, as we drop into the silence, like that holy night, let the joy of God be that shining star. Let the love of God be the light that circulates within. And with every breath, just going deeper and deeper into the awareness of the presence of the I Am. That is your very life, your very light, your very love. Breathing in love, exhale, radiating joy. Continuing this dance of the divine, just for a few minutes, going deeper and deeper into the truth of the I Am, that I am. That you are right here, right now. Breathing in and breathing out. And just continue in whatever way makes you feel comfortable. Breathing in love. Breathing out joy as you radiate it from your heart. With every breath going deeper and deeper, also see your light shining brighter and brighter. Just imagine all of this love, all of this joy circulating in the world. That promise of peace that was birthed 2,000 years ago reveals itself in each person's heart. And knowing that your light shines bright, awakening in others the truth of their being. That the Christ within is the Christ that is everywhere. So let us breathe in love, radiate joy, keeping our hearts open in childlike wonder, anchored and grounded in the truth of our beingness, of the one presence, the divine presence, the source of all of life that illuminates each one of us. And for this last minute, just take time to bring someone into your awareness, or bring a part of the world into your awareness, into your heart, where you may radiate that love, radiate that joy, and allowing the sacred energy to lift all who are seeking to be lifted and being that light in the world. Breathing in love, breathing out joy and radiating it from our heart. In great gratitude for this celebration. In great gratitude for this remembrance. And in great gratitude for all that continues to reveal itself. Let us know that we are anchored in this good. We are called to be the light. And in those times of our own darkness, we accept the light that is given to us by those in our life. One more deep breath. Breathe in love. Breathe out joy. Bring in your attention and your awareness to this room, feeling that joy circulating, feeling that love circulating, with a smile on your face and a smile in your heart. When you are ready, gently open your eyes and know that you are loved. Veronica Valles, it is an honor and a privilege to be here. So just let's take a few minutes, kind of like herding cats though when I let you loose, but go greet each other just for a few moments and come back, all right? So just give yourself, stand up, give each other a hug and lots of love.
Thank you.
some hugs up front, so come on. Love Mama, come on. Afterwards, thank you. Afterwards. To everybody that is on Facebook or online,
hi.
Hi. Merry Christmas Eve. Do you want a hug?
Merry Christmas, y'all. I'm Sasha.
All right, let's come on back.
Marianne.
Slowly
Sasha.
But surely.
Valerie, nice to meet you. Merry Christmas.
Feel that love, which is the reason for the season, right? So we're going to move through a new thought ritual. And I'm just going to invite you to keep your hearts and minds open. Because from the beginning of time, there's been a promise for light to show the way. A promise that we are inseparable from the Creator. And in the light of that heavenly star that guided the wise men is love. And today, we see that love within us. This Christmas Eve, let's rededicate ourselves to embody that love, the birth of peace and love and goodwill to all. Prophecy that a child would be born, one who by their very nature would bring peace, balance, and harmony to this world. Avatars are true embodiments of spiritual perfection. Jesus was born, one of the spiritual avatars who had completely embodied the true consciousness of this oneness within. And we too have this consciousness. The Christ principle is within and personal, and we honor and celebrate the radiant light within that is everywhere. So today, as we commemorate the birth of this Christ child into humanity, we realize that we are all part of that story. It is a story of our own consciousness. So symbolically, we are going to follow that star that shone so brightly over 2,000 years ago, heralding the angels, wise men, and all people to this significant event. And in truth, it doesn't matter if Jesus was born in Bethlehem 1,000 times if the Christ consciousness is not awakened within us now. That was his true purpose. So together we are gathered to follow a star, the star of intuitive knowing that the pure consciousness of the Christ truly dwells in every being. Let us lay aside our little selves and be led by the light of that first Christmas. So the spirit of humankind is this divine candle. It is a living quality of spirit because it so clearly says something about us that we are more than just physical form. The candle represents spirit in action, burning as the outward sign of the inward life. The flame on the candle is always moving, adapting itself to its environment, radiating light and warmth. And as ever leaping and reaching higher, so is the spirit of Christ within us. We are the light of the world. To rekindle that flame, which is the action of God within us, we have met here today. So the Trinity candle is the Christ candle, which is always lit because it's always existed and never goes out. Jesus brought Christ consciousness to its fullest expression, the eternal self. Before Abraham was, I am. Our Christ candle consists of three wicks. Each wick represents aspects of God being or the creative process of life. And metaphysically, we understand the Trinity to refer to spirit, soul, and body. One wick on the red candle represents the active and self-conscious principle, first cause or God, the absolute essence of all that is, the great I am. The other wick represents the soul, the law, spirit, the formative principle. And the third wick represents the body, the effect of the manifest world of form. So I'm gonna invite LD to light one candle. And this candle represents love. It's there. We have an extra one too. There we go. See, it's always there. So this candle represents love. And so when we go within, we know that God is love. We know that God loves the world and that love is flowing in the hearts of all people. The birth of Christ in your heart and mind is a flowing of that love into the world. Many events of the Christmas story show love. The angels sing of their love. The shepherds come and show their love. The wise men have traveled very far, following the star to express their love. The star shone brightly in the east and went before the wise men until it came and stood over the place where the child was. They followed the star, representing intuition, and it guided them to Bethlehem, meaning bread, symbolizing spiritual sustenance. Then they rejoiced as they saw the child. With faith and divine guidance, we also follow our star of intuition to the inner sanctuary of the soul to behold the newborn child. We follow with our hearts, led by the light. We sense and feel the surging of the power of love. And all of the old is forgotten, and anything unlike the Christ bows down in its presence. We feel an urge to experience the Christ consciousness more fully. So repeat after me. I feel the love of God within my soul.
I feel the love of God within my soul.
Within my heart.
Within my heart.
And within my body.
And within my body.
The next candle represents joy. There were shepherds in that part of the country who were spending the night in the fields, taking care of their flocks. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone over them. They were terribly afraid, but the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto us a child is born, a son is given, and the government shall be on his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace." The Christ is reborn in us because of our awareness of it. The Christ principle has always been there, waiting to be recognized. And we experience the healing energy of pure joy as we proclaim joy to the mind, joy to the heart, joy to the body, joy to the world of our affairs, joy to the world of our relationships. Repeat after me. I am joy in the world.
I am joy in the world.
Our next candle represents light. The wise men offered the Christ child gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And in a dream, God warned them not to go back to Herod. So they returned to their country a different way. And like the wise men who recognized the radiant Christ light, we acknowledge the light of Christ in all humankind. The wise men came from the east, and the east represents the within, our inner consciousness. The wise men represent the wisdom that is carried within the soul from previous incarnations, the stored up resources of the soul, which rise up to the surface when its depths are stirred by a great spiritual revelation. Just as the wise men departed in a new direction, protected by the light of spirit, so also when we leave the manger of our heart, holding the realization of oneness, which has been birthed, we will never go back to the old way of thinking. We find that Christ light within us, and it opens us up to a new viewpoint. We are led into the paths of peace and the paths of plenty. The light walks with us, living in our minds and hearts, and we learn that God is mightier than any situation or circumstance, and our way is lighted with new understanding. The gift of the Magi represent the inner resources of spirit, which are open to the Christ mind. God represents the riches of spirit. Gold represents the riches of spirit, frankincense, the beauty of spirit, and myrrh, the eternity of spirit. So repeat after me. God is the light of life within me.
God is the light of life within me.
That light guides me in new ways.
That light guides me in new ways.
This new candle, this next candle is the candle of life. Now let us, each of us turn within. And we are the candle of life. And let's imagine that our own heart is a manger of love, joy, and light. And in the manger of our hearts, the Christ consciousness awakens and is born in us. Christ, of course, was not born 2,000 years ago, because that would be to say that Christ did not exist before that. That would not be true, for Christ is a spiritual principle, the perfect idea of humankind in the mind of God. The Christ is eternal. Jesus Christ, our elder brother, our master teacher, our way shower, is an expression of the Christ principle just as you and I are. There is only one life. That life is God. That life is my life now. And that God life within each one of us gives us energy, strength, and vitality. It gives us the urge to grow and become all we can be. Feel the life of God stirring and vibrating throughout your body, your mind, and your spirit. And repeat after me. There is one life. That life is God's life. And that life is my life now. The next candle represents peace. Peace is a state of inner calm, that which is God. An inner calm so complete that nothing can disturb it. This is the peace which comes from the knowledge that it is all. Glory to God in the highest on earth, peace and goodwill toward all. As we keep our minds on the spirit within, we give God a chance to bring love where there was once hate, joy where there was sorrow, peace where there was chaos. Conflicts grow only in warlike minds. Peace grows only in Christ-like minds. And where there is peace, there's no adversary that affects any part of the whole. Adversary. All is calm, and the silence of our soul worships the indwelling presence. The Christ is revealed to us through our consciousness of oneness with God. And the Christmas star is a star of peace. Let each of us feel the peace of God, the peace that transcends all human understanding. Repeat after me. God's peace lifts my mind and heart.
God's peace lifts my mind and heart.
And the last is the light of beauty that encompasses all of this. Mary gave birth to her first son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in the manger because there was no room for them to stay. So no matter what things look like on the outside, the Christ within us is our true beauty. So the lowly stable is somewhat like our lives before we know we are one with spirit. It is not always very pretty, but when we know that Christ is born within us, true beauty makes itself revealed as our reality. We have balance and wholeness of mind. We have clarity of vision and see the infinite beauty in each one of God's creations. We recognize the beauty in ourselves. So repeat after me, I find beauty around me every day.
I find beauty around me every day.
I see beauty in myself and all.
I see beauty in myself and all.
So here's the invitation, that today we open our whole being to the influx of spirit, that the incarnation of the eternal Christ is our very life, to the Son of the Almighty God, but the Mother, Father, God that we experience and express, to know that you're one with this living Christ and one with the divinity of all people. And this same Christ manifesting in, through, and everything is the expression of the One, which is the only creation, the manifestation of spirit here and now. So the mystery that has been hidden throughout the ages and generations has now been revealed, which is the Christ in you, the hope of glory. Jesus Christ came into this world fully awakened to his divinity, fully aware of the Christ presence expressing in and through him. And the wonder of Christmas is this, that when we look to Jesus, the baby, or when we look to Jesus, the man, we see not only a human being, but we also see the Christ of God, the purity of consciousness. We see God in humankind as humankind. That is the miracle of Christmas. So here's the invitation, that we are going to come in adoration of the Christ. Not that one, we're coming over here, all right? Because there's a Jesus here, we're gonna have a Jesus there, all right? But the invitation is, Joseph is out getting breakfast, that's why he's not here right now. But the invitation is that all these qualities of God reside within us. That this is what Jesus brought to us. That revelation of the wholeness and the allness, the beauty and the peace and the love, it resides within us. So when I held my great niece, Caroline, she's a little over 2 months ago, but during Thanksgiving, and I just held her, and I just gazed in the wonder and awe of life being born, of this new being, that adoration, that is the adoration that I am going to invite you one at a time to bring to the Christ. So we have a surprise Christ here. And the invitation is that we are going to line up here. And one at a time, you're going to gaze in adoration at the Christ. And then you're going to bring your candle, too, with you, and you're going to light from one of the candles. And just, when you get back to your place, just remain standing. So we'll just come in a way, if y'all want to play music, y'all can play music. If not, become like you're first. But we're going to come first. You're going to come. You're going to adore the Christ with so much love. Oh, just so cute. And then you're going to light the candle, and then you're going to go and then just take a stand. So first come and adore, then light. Take a good look at the Christ. Lots of love and adoration. Peeking. Maybe we'll have a little music in between. So contemplate love, beauty, life, joy, harmony, the peace that is God. Go ahead and line up, and then maybe we'll have a little guitar music. And then hang on to your candle. LD, you want to come first? No? Okay. So we'll start with Donna here. So go gaze in adoration at Christ, and then light your candle. Give it lots of love. We'll have you wait just right there. And light your candle. And feel that beauty, feel that love, feel that joy, feel that peace. Feel the life of God expressing as you. And love up that sweet Christ. Get up close and personal. Big smile. Take time to adore the Christ. Childlike wonder and awe. It takes one drop of light to dispel the darkness. And each one of us is that light. Christ just adorable. Just notice that. Smile. The perfection of Christ. Thank you. direction of God. Wonder, the joy, the love, peace, harmony, wisdom. Now take a look around the room as you recognize the Christ within all and the light that shines within each one of our hearts. Like the wise men who brought great gifts, your heart is the gift to the world. Your light is a gift to the world. You're necessary. God had a need to express and experience itself in through and as each one of you. So we take that beauty of that child born in a manger, of a mother who said yes, despite the uncertainty of a father and his willingness to step into the mystery, that this beloved Christ child was born to awaken in each of us, the light that is our life. That every time you look in the mirror and every time you look at someone, you see the Christ light. And in those moments when they may be acting from a place of amnesia, you shine your light to remind them of their light. And the more light that we circulate, the brighter the world becomes. The more the love that we radiate, peace prevails. And that this Christ consciousness that is our very life, this sweet baby that you got to smile at, that is your very life, is precious. May we always remember this truth. So as we breathe into this awareness, I invite you just to take into your heart the love and the joy and the beauty and the grace and that wisdom of God to know that it's here now, and in those moments when you forget, you have all of each other to remind each other of this truth. Let yourself be lifted. Let yourself be guided. Let yourself be loved, for that was the whole purpose of Christ, to remind us that we are love incarnate. And that each one of us is a necessary expression of God. And that the beauty of God is always present, no matter what the world may want to have us think. No. We stand in the light, and we stand in the love, and we stand in the joy, and we stand in the truth of this beloved child. And we embrace that within, and we embrace that with each other. So just take a deep breath with me. And if you are committed to being that light in the world, even though we're going to blow out the light, you know, I just invite you to say, I am that I am.
I am
light.
I am joy.
I am peace.
I am love.
I am wisdom.
I am beauty.
And I am grateful. So take a breath. And as you blow out your candles, make sure when you sit that you don't drop any wax on you. Have a seat. Let the music carry us forward in prayer. And the reminder that each one of us is indeed here is a perfect expression of the living God. And that if you ever forget, we are here to remind you. And to daily remember the truth of who you are. To look in the mirror and to see God and only God. And may this Christmas and every day be the day of love and the day of light. May you be that beneficial presence in the world. And may you live with that grace that just reveals itself in every moment. And with great gratitude, I honor the light in each one of you.
most beautiful Christmas Eve experiences I've ever had. I'll never forget it. Thank you. This song is going to make each one of you really think about our lives and what we've done and what we are doing and what we are potential, you know, what our potential is to do in the future. So listen to the lyrics and really take them inside with you and on into the new year.
So this is Christmas, and what have you done? Another year over, and a new one just begun. And so this is Christmas.
Sunday lessons all at once. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, guys. Our new minister affirmation. We are holding space for a new spiritual leader here at Unity on Greenville. We are affirming the arrival of that leader, and it is reflected in our affirmation that's on the screen. Let's say it together. We embrace with love, joy, and harmony a creative and dedicated spiritual leader who will bring positivity and connection with our community at Unity on Greenville. Thank you. Did you guys advance me? Thank you. Our core values are on the screen. Those reflect in part what we believe here at Union on Greenville, who we are as a community, as a people. So let's say those core values together. Unconditional love, conscious spiritual transformation, spirit of service, acceptance and inclusion, expression of divine light. We want to remind you that you are invited to connect with us here in this community, and you can do that by going to dallasunity.org. Click on the connect button, and in that space you can leave a prayer request. If you have questions about the Unity movement, what we believe in, what we practice, you can do that there as well. Also, if you just want someone to reach out to you, there's a need, whatever the situation, go to dallasunity.org, click connect. You can also sign up for our newsletter, which is a great way of learning about what's going on here at Unity on Greenville. So please take advantage of that option, and someone will be in touch with you if you have a request. And now let's stand and sing our peace song.
Yes, there is peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God, our Creator, united all are we.
Now we walk with each other in perfect harmony.
Yes, there is peace on earth, for this is the moment now. With every step I take, I make this my joyous vow. I take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Yes, there is peace on earth. I know it begins in me.
Thank you, thank you. And now the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Go forth, shine your light, and you are necessary. Have a good week.